Hello, it's Jang here with a look at the LEGO Creator Ocean Explorer 3-in-1 set, and you will see all three official builds in this one video. Starting with this one, this is the main one that they focus on, and it uses all of the parts. It's very similar in its color scheme and its general function to one of the to the big ship that was included in this past summer season's city line in the deep sea exploration line, but this one does not have the split hull at the rear of it. Instead, it places the crane at the rear, right in the center. Makes a lot of sense, and this thing has a lot of depth to it. The ship itself, you see way down in there. I mean, it's really built up quite a lot. There's a lot of hollow space, but I think they do a good job of getting a lot of height out of it and making it feel substantial. You know, you build up a lot from relatively small pieces. No real large pieces are used for this. You do fully build up the sides of the hull. You add on the bow. It's actually attached from the side completely. Get a nice line here with the red. A little bit of, you know, little jitter right there, but it's okay. These are bumpers, you know, supposed to represent the tires around the sides. The crane can fold up a bit. Does have a friction joint at the end there with the hook on it, so it's not all that much that you can do with it, but it is able to hook onto the loop of the little included ROV. We'll take a closer look at that in just a minute, but useful parts. And you can also put the ROV itself into the ship. You can just set it right there and it will just stay in place. Because of the size of this thing, it's not completely unreasonable to put a minifigure on it. Why not? You know, yeah, it's off scale, but it is big enough to play with this thing with minifigures, I think. You're not going to be able to put any up in the bridge. I like what they've done with the bridge with a little extension off to the side. Some of the detailing on the top, including this single tile that is intended to represent a radar bar that would normally spin. You can even just put that, kind of offset it a little bit. It makes it look even more believable, I would say. It's just not that exciting of a thing to look at, in my personal opinion, just this ship by itself. I think it looks much better with the ROV on it, but there's something about it that's just a little bit on the plain side. Let me know what you think about that. Now, I've been calling this an ROV, but it could actually be a manned sub, given its scale. You know, this is a relatively large thing if you scale it the same as the ship. So that could actually be the little command capsule right there. Either way, you want to look at it. What I appreciate here is the use of the dual arms, which are posable. So you can actually bring these down and up because of the ball joints. Not a great range of motion, but you get a lot more range out to the sides. Of course, you can also rotate the hands around, and as a result, you can put little minifigure accessories in there, or, you know, one-by-one stud pieces or plates and tiles and things, and actually have some interactivity with this. Has its marker lights, red on the left always, and this is supposed to represent the main thrust propeller coming off the back of it. Let's see the second build. Now, this is a big fat cargo plane, and you recognize pretty quickly many of the pieces that came from the boat hull. This did use a fair number of pieces of the set on the whole. This one doesn't do anything. There's nothing on this model that moves or opens or anything like that. Kind of looks on the back like it has a little hinge there for the back. Just kind of simulated. That's a good use of that part there. I'm assuming this is a prop plane, but no, actually it could be a jet. I don't know. Could be either one. It's too bad that nothing opens up on this. Would have been nice to be able to just put some one-by-one bricks in it or something to represent cargo. This last build represents an underwater research vessel. That would definitely be manned. It would have multiple crew members working in it. And this is a fairly small scale still. It would be a relatively large craft for its class. And I think this one looks pretty good. Has a pretty nice level of detail to it. You've got your little yaw thrusters here and the lift thrusters as well. Plenty of lights, plenty of windows. Has the nice superstructure up at the top, the tower. You know, you've got your windows out to the front and to the sides. The main bubble in the front, which I think looks better in this scale. Still has the two moving arms can be rotated around and such, so you can actually use it to grab some things. I don't know what this exactly is, just because I haven't followed along with this type of craft in general. I don't know if that's supposed to go to the tether or if that's supposed to be a camera, because look at this. You can point it forward if you want to, but the way that they suggest is that you actually have it up. So that's why I don't fully know exactly what that's supposed to be. If you do know, feel free to comment about it. And then there's another little bit of detail on the side. That could also be a camera, or that could be for lights. Of course, it's got the lights up top as well. I think this is nicely done. It doesn't use many parts, but for what it is, I think that it captures the essence quite well. I like the color scheme. It works well for an underwater vehicle. Yeah, nice. Now here's one last thing. In the second instruction manual, in the very back of it, they show you this interesting thing. If you also purchase the chopper transporter set, 31043 right there, you can swap some things between the main build here and it. So you can take the crane off the back of the ship and place it onto the truck. It just fits right in with just a Technic pin adapter that fits in there. So you can use that with the remote, with the submersible vehicle. And you can also kind of land the helicopter on the deck. Gets a little bit cramped with that, but there is just enough space to get those skids on there. So that's nice. And a little bit of interoperability between a couple different sets. Post up a comment with your choice for which of these builds is your favorite. And also, if you have any thoughts about the set on the whole, feel free to share those as well. Thank you for watching. Talk to you again soon.